Hi everyone, in this quick tutorial I'll be walking you through how to create your first form, publishing a form, and how to use our form templates. The first step you will need to take is to sign into your Hushmail account on hushmail.com. Once you're signed in, you want to click on the Form Builder option in the top right hand corner. As this is our first form, it'll ask us to create our first form. So click on Create My First Form. This will bring you to a list of our general form templates and healthcare form templates. But first, I will show you how to create an empty or a blank form. Click on Create Empty Form. This will bring you to a completely empty form that you can add pretty much whatever you want to. So how the form builder works is it is a drag and drop system. So for example, let's say on my form, the first question was, what is your name? I would do the short text box, click on it and drag it and drop it into the actual box that was in the middle of that form. So you can change the name from short text to what is your name? Then once I send this form to my client, this empty box here will be where they actually enter their name. So on the left-hand side, we have quite a variety of different controls that you can use. So we have short text boxes. This can be used for, as I just did, the what is your name. It could be something just that needs quite a short answer. But let's say if you need them to describe something, you could use a long text box. Please describe. You also have a date option, you have checkbox options, you have electronic signatures. This is something that you can really create to suit your company and to suit the form that you want to create and send to your clients. So once you're happy with the form, you have to always make sure to click publish in the top left-hand corner. So publish is almost like, you know, a save button. So anytime you're making any edits or if you're creating a form, make sure to hit publish. Once you hit publish, you can click on return to form list, and that form is actually going to be listed there. So now that we've created a blank form, what I want to show you is how to use or utilize our form templates. So these are the form templates that we have. So we have some general templates. So we have an empty form that we just use. We have our contact form, and we also have a secure file transfer. So the healthcare forms are a little bit more detailed, you know, or orientated towards healthcare clients. So you can see here, we actually have quite a list of templates that you can use. So if you're looking through these templates and one of them catches your eye and you think, this might be very suitable for me and for my clients, all you have to do is click on preview or use underneath the title and the description. So for example, I want to use the COVID-19 screening questionnaire. All I have to do is click on preview or use. And you'll see here that it's actually a preview of the form. Now this preview of the form is how the form will look when you send it to your recipient. So it's a good way to kind of, you know, preview it and see how your client will see it and how your client will interact with it. So if you're happy and you think, okay, this might suit, all you have to do is click on use this template. Then it's going to bring you back to what we've seen earlier on when we were creating our form from scratch in the empty form. This is basically where you can edit the form. So not all of our forms and our form templates are going to be completely suited to what you want. They might be, which would be great, but if they're not, you can always make edits. So for example, let's say in the symptom history, I didn't need to have fever or chills. All I would need to do is click on it and click delete. And it's gone. I can also add to it if I wish. So let's say if I actually needed to have the client's address, I would use our short text box. And as you can see, this is definitely something worth noting. So when you're dragging and dropping into the middle of a form, or you know, you're not necessarily adding it to the very, very end, you want to insert it in the middle or towards the top, you'll see that this blue line appears, okay? So the blue line is basically your indicator for where this control is going to drop. So I want to drop this just underneath the email address and phone number. But let's say if I wanted to drop it in between the phone number and the email address, I could do that too. And you can actually see that the blue line appears just between them. So in this example, I'm just going to drop it underneath the email address and phone number. The blue line appears. I let go. And there it is. So I can again change short text to address, hit apply, and now that's been added to my form. So you can edit this as much as you wish. You can add, you can delete, it's completely up to you. You could even change the title of your form if you want. You could, you know, add your name here in the subtitle instead of having this comment. It's, you know, you can personalize it as much as you want to make it work for you and for your clients. On the right hand side, I just want to note that these two boxes here, so we do give you the option, you know, to add some more information about yourself, so your name, your job title, your, you know, your website URL, you can put your social networks in here if you want, and you can even add a picture of yourself or your company logo. You can do that. A lot of people use the click to add important information for emergency contact information if you want to add that in there. But if you don't want to use these two boxes, it's good to note that if you leave them blank, they will not appear on the form. You know, if you have any information in there, of course it'll appear, but if they're completely blank, they won't appear on the form. They won't be two empty boxes on the right hand side of your form, so you have nothing to worry about there. Okay, so I have made the edits to my template and now I'm happy, so I want to publish this template. So that's been saved now to my account, and we can see that by clicking on return to forms list. So there it is. So I have my COVID-19 questionnaire and I have the, you know, the new form or the blank form that I created earlier on. So these two are going to be available for me now to actually send to my clients. So a quick way to get back to your Hushmail mail account from the form builder is by clicking in the top right hand corner, these three little lines, and click on go to Hushmail. This will then bring us back to our mail account, and I'm going to show you how to send these forms to your clients. So to send these forms, you just want to click on compose in the top left-hand corner. You can then enter in your recipient's email address, a subject line, so please complete form. And you'll see the option here to add a form. So when I click on add form, these two forms that I've just created appear. So this is how I would actually send them to my clients through email. So I can send one at a time, or I can send both at the same time. So I would just tick the box beside the name of the form I want to send and click on add forms. You can write a little email in the body if you wish, you know, hi, how are you? Please sign these forms. And once they've actually submitted these forms, the submissions come straight back to you into your Hushmail account, so you'll have everything in the same place. So it's really, really good like that. So that's the basics of creating your first form using our templates, publishing, and I've also added just how to send the form by email to your clients. And that's that, guys. Thank you so much. I really hope that this was helpful. Please feel free to reach out to us on support@hushmail.com, or you can call us on 877-533-4874. We'd be more than happy to help if you have any questions. Thanks again. Take care. Bye-bye.